इष्टान् भोगानि वो देवा दास्यन्ते यज्ञभाविताः तेर्दत्तान प्रधायेभ्यो यो भुङ्क्ते स्तेन एव सः.
So just like a victorious king is invited by a vanquished king and showered with gifts, put on a pedestal, showered with gifts, in a similar way, the mighty devas shall bring to you whatever you desire when they are nourished by sacrifices. That is what Bhagavan is saying. He is saying the gods, deva, yajna bhavitaha, nourished by sacrifice. The devas nourished by sacrifice, dasayante, will give to you. Ishtan bhogan, desired objects, whatever you desire. And then, however, a person who receives and enjoys nature's bounty without offering or sharing, that person, God gives that person a title. So the God says, indeed, dattan, given by them, dattan tair, tair dattan means given by them, apradaya means without offering, to whom? To them. You got it from the nature, but you are not offering to the nature. Apradyayaibhyo, to offering to nature. And this person who bhungte, enjoys, eva saha, surely that person is stena. Stena means a thief. So a person who receives and enjoys nature's bounty without offering back, actually without first giving. You know, in the previous verse, Bhagavan said, you first nourish and then you will be nourished right back. But forget about first nourishing. Receiving but not nourishing. Receiving but not giving. That person gets the title of a thief by Bhagavan. Mahatma Gandhi said, the world has sufficient for everyone's need, but not for one person's greed. On the other hand, Bhagavan continues,
Yajna shishtashina santo bhujyante sarva kilbishaihi bunjate te twagam papa ye pachantyatma karanat.
Yajna shishtashina, one who enjoys what remains after sacrifices. Santo, the noble soul, that noble person. Muchyante sarvakilbishaihi. Muchyante is are freed. Sarvakilbishaihi, from all sins, from all the impurities. Te, those who, ye is who. Pachan is cook. Pachanti. Pachanti means to cook. Atmakaranat. Atmakara. Pachanti atmakaranat. Who cook for their own sake. Who do things for their own sake. They indeed are wicked, sinful people. So Bhagavan says, those who enjoy the remains after sacrifice, whatever is left over after. When a guest comes home, do we start eating first? We wait for the guest to eat. Sometimes, in fact, some people I have seen, they don't eat at all till the guest has finished completely. At least people like us, you know, we wait for the guest to have the first morsel, and then for me, for example, I will wait for the guest to eat, the first take the plate and start eating, and I'll take. I've been to homes where they do not touch the food till we are done and put the plate aside. Then they will eat. So those who enjoy what remains after nourishing others. And how do you nourish others? Bhagavan has given us 5 yajnas that takes care of all creation. These such people are freed from all sins, all the impurities, the shadrikus. But on the contrary, those who cook and consume for themselves, for their own sake, they are indeed wicked and sinful. Now, this is in Bhagavad Gita, this is in the scriptures. But, you know, I was so surprised and so actually I had goosebumps. I was watching this Netflix series called Our Planet. Beautifully made Netflix series called Our Planet. And I'm going to just quote from that series. Okay, this is not one word, is mine, entirely quoted from there. Nature was created and its relationships of mutual giving have taken millions of years to evolve. However, because of one species, the humans, this could all be gone in a decade. In the last 20 years, poaching for bushmeat has halved the gorilla population in the Congos. They and the elephants, that is the gorillas and the elephants, they are the gardeners of the jungle. The seed dispersers. I didn't know this, okay? They are the gardeners. The elephant, these huge creatures, they are the gardeners of the jungle, the seed dispersers. Many trees owe their existence to these large animals. Elephants are poached for their tusks, whereas gorillas are poached for the bushmeat. And the depletion in their population results in the loss of these mega seed dispersers, leading to loss of megafauna. The megafauna, I mean, these forests, they are so rich. Even if we go to the Western Ghats, unbelievably rich forests. And in the last 10 years, you know, I've been living in Bangalore since, you know, the late 90s, but the last 10 years I've seen, there is humongous depletion in the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats, the forests. This will have far-reaching impact on the future of our planet's second largest rainforest. The diversity of the rainforest depends on no one species gaining the upper hand. And here the humans have this crazy upper hand. This is quote unquote, unquote from Netflix, the Our Planet. Encourage you to watch. So let us hope that our planet overcomes the assault of human beings and human beings learn to live using the principles of Karma Yoga, which are to care, to share, to reciprocate, to give forward, and then to receive.